Here we go.
City in a funky cheap hotel. She took my heart, she took my money. Must have slipped me a sleeping pill. She never drinks the water, makes you order French champagne. Once you've had a taste of her, you'll never be the same. Yeah, she'll make you go insane.
Come on, outside, inside out.
She's living la vida loca.
Holy Jesus. Welcome, everybody. Welcome. I just want to say that it is with mixed emotions that I really hate that song, but I really love that version of the song right now.
That's fucking badass.
Comments are fucking killing me.
I honestly don't know whether I should hate myself now for liking that song so much. Or love Adam for doing such a fantastic job at making me love that and hate myself at the same time. Because that's kind of what it feels like.
Like, this is, I think this is probably the most fun you had on a song, if I had to guess, just based on kind of the passion that's in the song. Like, I can tell you had a really good fucking time with this one.
I had no idea what the words were either for that one. And it's like, he's like date raped in the second verse.
Yeah. He
gives him a sleeping pill.
Yep.
Does that mean the next one we should do should be Sublime's Date Rape?
You know, oh, no.
Just to kind of...
I don't know if Date Rape ever charted. I don't know if that's even
allowed.
I think
allowed. It did.
Did Date Rape chart?
Yeah.
But it had Ron Jeremy in the video, so...
I'm just saying. They did have some big names there. Let's say hello to some people out there. I see James Rivera is out there. There's Vape. Swag is out in the house. Doomtooth, JFM... Marzia, Lino's out there, Kim Dixon, the Vapor Cat is here. Been a while since we've seen him. How's it going, Vapor Cat?
Vapor Cat!
Yeah, Hippie Vapes is in the house. Master Burbs. That's what I got out there. Hoss is in the house. Holy Hoss!
Hoss!
How long gone?
I bet you Hoss was dancing all around his place. Living La Vida Loca. Like, if anybody's going to be bouncing around, it's going to be fucking Hoss.
Raven Shadows out there. Rodrigo's back. What's happening, Rodrigo?
Rodrigo!
James Burr is still out there.
From Brazil.
Erwin's in the house tonight.
Erwin Kopecky. What's up, man?
Oh, crikey, he's a beauty.
Michael Morris is out there. We have a Jesse. We also have a Spork Reefy.
Spork Reefy!
What's out there? As I'm slowly going down through the list here. Oh, yeah, my brother Eric's in the house. What's happening there, babyface Sutherland? There's a pillar of Zach. Is that how that's pronounced?
A pillar of Zach.
Holy shoot! Look who's here. What up, fucker?
What up, fuckers? It's International Whiskey Day.
Hell yeah.
Is it every day International Drink Something Day for you?
I think it's for everybody.
Yes.
Oh, Lumi comes this like life. It comes in, and Lumi just comes out swinging.
If you're gonna spew into this,
that was well kind.
life is leaning in for a hug and just catches a right cross.
Story of my fucking life.
What's happening,
this
brother?
Is the story of all of our lives, life.
Hey, I did something good. I did something good.
Mac.
Yeah.
Get back down, you.
Like, aw.
You sit down when you pee. You sit down when you pee.
Isn't that a rule? Isn't that a rule? If it's a toilet, you sit down. If it's a urinal, you stand up. That's how I was always taught.
I'm right? Sorry.
Did you grow up in a household full of women?
I did.
No, it's like I've heard that it's like some parts of the military are like that too. I don't know.
No, that's only if you're fucking sloppy and can't make it in a fucking hole that's fucking 2 foot around.
That's I believe that's Navy protocol / Coast Guard protocol.
I feel so
I guess when you're in a boat, that makes sense. Because, I mean,
yeah.
You're fucking all over. Your shit's just going to be like a goddamn elephant playing in the water.
I don't clean the bathroom, so I'm nice.
Is anybody here going to get me the shiwi so I can relate to this?
The shiwi.
Like, are you going to get the shiwi and just, like, attach, like a six-inch rubber hose to it and just pretend?
No, I'm going to attach a flaccid dildo to it.
So that way she can sit
around. What's the point of a flaccid dildo? Do you just get, like, kind of slap yourself in the vagina with it, like drunk guys do?
I could do the helicopter. Talk about and rave about.
All right. Before we get too far off track here, there's something I did want to follow up on from last week, since we had the late show, because I was at that city meeting there for the ban on vaping in public places to include vape shops. Did want to give a heads up as far as what will happen post-vote there. They did indeed pass the vote to ban it in all places. However, they did, on a 12-2 vote, put an exclusion for vape shops. So vape shops are now excluded from it. So it was kind of a win. It wasn't a complete win, however.
Give and take.
Kind of expected the rest of those to go because they're still cocksuckers who are stupid and blow clouds in fucking Olive Garden while they're ordering their unlimited breadsticks and salad.
Mm.
That I kind of expected. However, I think I'm still more pissed off about the way they demonized everything. But just wanted to give you guys a quick heads up on what is going on there, what happened post-vote there with everybody who showed up and actually spoke their minds. So just another example of, yes, if you show up, you can swing a vote in your local municipalities, even if it's not your local municipality, because that's not mine. That's a 30-minute drive. I went and spoke anyways. Because it's close enough to where it made a difference in their lives. So definitely worth your while. Make sure you do go and show up for those types of things. Also, there's a bunch of fights going on out there today. I'm seeing there was some stuff in LA. I think Sacramento just had something.
There's yep, the fight is on.
All over. Everywhere. So it's crazy. Just pay attention.
In my little town of Waverly, they're looking at public parks and smoking and tobacco use in public park.
You should go see if there's
smokers that put their butts on the ground in parks.
That's a douchebag move. You field strip your cigarettes, everybody. You grab it right at the top of the filter and you roll your fingers down. You're not going to burn yourself, and the ember falls on the ground. You stomp the ember out. You take what's left. And you go throw it in a trash can.
And if
there's any smoker that's out there, that's called field stripping your cigarette.
And if you don't have a trash can, you stuff that bitch in your cargo pocket if you have cargo pants on.
That's
might as well. You already smell that cigarette. butt in your pocket isn't gonna make you smell any better.
That's
it. So, Sin, you wanted to know what you wandered into. My advice would be to go back to the very beginning of the show, listen to the song that played at the start of the show, and then come back to us here live, and then wonder why we are the way we are tonight.
Exactly. In fact, Roro came in, noticing that we were just talking about the same thing. Sorry, Sin. And Roro,
what's up, Roro?
Welcome to the party, talking about slapping people's vaginas with flaccid dildos. Tonight's topic.
Just another day.
Like, I guarantee that's happening somewhere in the army right now. Like, some drunk guy is trying to, like, trying to get his flaccid penis into some poor drunk girl's vagina. That's I guarantee it's happening right now.
Do you know how bad it would be if I had a strap-on flaccid penis? I'd be trying to stick it into everything.
Says, why doesn't it work?
Why does this work like in the movies?
The movies.
All right, we're getting right into it today. What do you guys have going on this week other than making me hate and love myself all at the same time?
You heard it. That's about it.
Work was really long. I was out of town for the weekend. Well, part of the weekend. My mom was in town, then she had to go back on Saturday. Then I took off out of town Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, and then I came back. Today was my first day back at work, and it sucked.
The first day back always sucks.
Yeah.
I've had an eventful couple of days. I started working more on, like, letting options be known towards what coils I sell. So last night I made myself a little watermark. Adam did not enjoy me doing that at all because he was like, click this, no this, this.
He's trying to give her a refresher course on Photoshop, and I am the worst teacher of all time because I'm an impatient motherfucker.
And I'm just sitting there clicking everywhere, and he's like, oh wait, that's I was talking about my mouse because he had his mouse up, and he's like, your mouse is right on it. I was like, my mouse is on my second monitor. But I was able to make myself a watermark, and I'm starting up photos of examples of my coils along with the price next to them, so I actually have like a little catalog now, so I feel pretty proud of that.
Lino, I like your idea. He shall forever be known as Adam Martin from now on.
Adam Martin?
Yep.
Orale.
Are you going to start putting product in your hair too now?
You have to have hair to put product in it.
Fair enough.
You just put baby oil on the scalp and beard oil on the face.
Just spike your beard out in different directions. You'll be all right.
I mean, it goes up pretty high.
What about you, Lisa? How is National Whiskey Day treating you so far?
My whiskey day, this is one of these big cups. Hey, but highlight of the day, Canada Dry. Liked my picture on Instagram. That was awesome. Still waiting to hear back from Jameson. That sponsorship, that would be great, but I'm sure they're still not woke up from St. Patrick's Day yet, so who knows. Things are good. I woke up early this morning, did a morning show. Some people were there, some people were there, they're in the audience, and that's kind of crazy because we're still up.
I'm a creepy
one. I'm only going to be on here for a little bit, but yeah, we did 3:30 a.m. Central Time to 4:30 a.m.
Jesus Christ. Nice time.
Well, I kind of wake up about that time anyways because I work at 5. So I figured I'd wake up just a little bit earlier on Wednesdays and Thursdays and catch some of the Australian crew, the UK crew, the people in the States that can't sleep, the people that are up early with me. And the cool thing is I'm getting heard back that the replay is getting played in the car on their way to work sometimes. So it's a nice spot. I don't have to worry about anybody else going up against me at that time.
It's true.
Oh, you've made a lifetime enemy with vaping with Vic.
He does it on Sunday.
That early morning, I don't think there's too many out there that are going to be doing that early. I mean, the good part of that is nice. Pick up the international crowd that way, at least international in the sense of outside of the U.S. I mean,
And you know how it gets. You get that little burst of excitement when you hit that live button, and then you see the chat, and your eyes light up, you smile that people are in here having a good time. What a way to start Wednesdays and Thursdays early. Like, by Wednesday, I hate work, just like Fresh hates work today. But after doing an hour of talking to my peeps, it was great. I could just roll right into work with a good mood. Now, it didn't last that long. It was like 10 o'clock. I still hated work. But I know I got Friday to look forward to.
You know, I'm not even lying. I'm impressed you made it till 10 o'clock before you hated work again. Me, that might be like fucking 30 minutes of it. Fuck this shit. I feel great every morning. I wake up, I'm like, all right, I get to try this all over. Maybe today's going to be better. Nope. By 6:37, it's all fucked.
Glam Tam in the house.
The lady in black.
I did get something new. Sorry, yesterday. I got a new iJoy Zenith 3. Actually, I got two of them yesterday. I bought two more while they're still $36 at my vapor store.
Nice.
That's a pretty good deal.
Last forever. I had the last one since the middle of September, and it's still going. I pressed the button a couple times last week, and you could smell hot electronics. Hey. So, you know, it's getting into that switch, and slowly one of these times we got to push on that button, and it's just not going to work.
Yep. There is that spot where it hits where you can just tell. You're like, yep, I might have five more uses out of this, and we're done.
I used to have a computer teacher that one of my computer hardware teachers, and says, in those chipboards in the processor, the Chinese put a little bit of smoke in there. That way, when it's time to replace it, it just lets the smoke out, and you smell it.
They do know fireworks, so, I mean, that's... Not completely unplausible theory.
That's a hell of a time release.
True that.
Thank you, Lando. Speaking of which, who's watched what Bill Murray this week? What movies?
I did actually watch What About Bob.
Yes.
Just because it's been years since I've seen it, and and you forget how fucking hilarious Bill Murray is in that movie. Like, he's so out of it. Like, it's one of the perfect Murray performances, just because he's able to just take it to so many different extremes. And then Richard Dreyfuss might be about his best movie that he's ever done.
Absolutely.
Night, Roro.
My Roro.
Night, Roro.
Mr. Burgundy.
Giner.
Giant. Whale's a vagina.
Well, actually, I was watching. I watched something with a cameo with him in it. I watched. I watched Zombieland with my son the other day because he's into zombies lately. 3 years old, like zombies. All right, cool.
That is one of the best zombie movies ever made.
I'm just saying.
And they're working on the second right now.
Yeah, it's going to be amazing.
Goddamn Twankies.
I did watch The Dirt on Netflix.
The Dirt was fantastic.
It is freaking awesome. The amount of times they broke the third wall to clue you in on what was really happening behind the scenes was...
This is Bill. He's actually a really nice guy, but he's not in the movie.
Yeah. I really need to watch that now, because you know what? I keep seeing the previews for it. And I'm like, I need to watch this. I need to watch.
I love shit like that, like meta shows like that.
Yeah, I mean, it's the story of Motley Crue, you know, according to Nikki Sixx. So.
Yeah.
Sounds like a good time right there as is.
Yeah, I mean, it's hilariously awesome just to see, although just you know, you've heard all the stories, but seeing it all getting acted out on screen, it's pretty fun.
Whatever you do, don't bring your girlfriend around Vince Neil.
That's ever. Right. Ever. You will fuck her.
There's a great part, and I'll just reference this without ruining it for
you. I mean, it happened in real life. I'm not sure what this how many spoilers apply.
The fucking tattoo moment. Where he lifts up his arm, and he goes, "Tommy changed the name of the album the other night."
Whoops.
Did you catch that?
Yeah. I love it. Just the look on the guy's face. He's like, mm-hmm. Then they walk away and he's like.
It's gotta suck.
Later, Marzia. Or Marzias. Marzias? I'm not sure how to say that, whatever. You know who the fuck you are. Good night.
Marsias?
Marsias, sure. Sure. Sounds good.
Or Marzias.
I'm gonna go with Marzias.
Marzias?
Marzias. Just because it sounds like Marzias.
McMars, yes.
McMars, yes.
That girl, yeah, slay.
Yes. Get more coffee, I'll be back.
Cafe. I don't drink that shit. Stunts my growth. And to be quite frank, I don't like it.
Marcius. I was right the first time, so.
It's all right. You're ever known as Mars, yes.
Mars, yes.
Mars, yes. It sticks.
It sticks. It's stuck.
If we stumble onto something and we're mildly amused by it, it sticks.
Ask Stroker.
That's right.
Sticker.
Yeah. Well, if it diddles our diddles, we're going to diddle it some more. That's how that works.
Just know it's because of love.
That's right.
Exactly.
No.
Marzias is on board. So.
Yes!
way to embrace it. Lean into it. That's how you do it.
That's right. Just don't push back. Otherwise, it's gay. Right. I mean, unless you're into that kind of thing, then by all means, do so. Yeah. I'm not here to judge.
Crank your motor, then turn, baby, turn.
That's it. It floats your boat, sail away. Come on, let's go. Let's keep on going. I'll do this all day. Meter, what's happening, buddy? And take it, you're a little late because you were knee-deep in some Satan salad there, huh?
I think it is safe to say that I went a little too ham in the salad aiming for the space station and ended up on Mars.
Yeah, so you ended up a little dusty and red, huh?
Very. Lacking oxygen, bright red.
What about the memes with Thanos and Ant-Man? Is he the stuff going around?
Who's what now?
The memes going out about Thanos and Ant-Man. It's like, Thanos' face as just before he dies, because the whole thought on the internet is that the Ant-Man just makes himself bigger right in Thanos' asshole.
I mean that's,
if you can get past those infinity underoos, then go for it.
Yeah, didn't he have like golden underoos on?
He had like the super armor.
Yeah.
It's like the.
Although he did have it hanging on a scarecrow at the end of the movie.
That's true. Oh. That's true. He is susceptible, but then you're also post snap. Yep. Thanos is susceptible, and you got to go backwards.
Yeah, I mean, he could. There could be a rectal breach.
He could do it just for fun, and then go back in time and then kill him, which you know.
Or maybe he gets a flaccid dildo and throws it up in there, all small like, and then just. Poof! There goes.
Well, the
just learned.
Shoot them off the like other, those 20 or 2 liter bottle foot pump rockets.
That other meme that I seen was like this girl with all kinds of like Cheeto dust around her mouth and on her tongue. And it says, damn, Thanos snapped his fingers while some guy was getting a blowjob.
Yeah.
That's awesome.
That is fantastic. Apparently, Lando has a golden Thanos thong.
Probably doesn't get invited anymore.
I mean, that's. I mean, it kind of explains the song choices.
Definitely does.
Just dancing around in a golden thong to Ricky Martin. Yeah.
Don't play with your infinity stones during the show is all I ask.
Oh, I'm so glad I didn't take a drink. Oh, shit.
The meter can make all those jokes that he wants while I'm drinking. I'm expecting meter's voice something like that. Lumi yelling at me while I'm taking the fucking
yeah, I'm sitting here getting my shit set up, and then Lumi drops this clean three-pointer and just walks away with her fucking hand up.
Just short. No, that I'm not even sure she like Reggie Miller style where he's backpedaling down the court like that. I'm thinking it's more Jordan style where she just turns around like.
I have that happen quite frequently. My I don't get along with my dad's side of the family. They're very naysayers. You should do this. You should do this with your life, kind of people. And I started turning around and saying just horrible things, not even realizing it. They don't talk to me anymore.
Just unleash the beast, Lumi. Just unleash the beast.
I like, it's a mix between, it's either going to be me coming back with a sassy comeback or me just trying to be funny. I wasn't trying to pick on you. I was being funny because
you don't know. Michael Jordan doesn't apologize when he nails a three-pointer on the Utah Jazz and walks away winning the NBA Finals.
Well, right. If I find out that it came off mean, then I feel bad because it's not my intention. Normally just me being a smart ass.
We've all got pretty good sense of humor on this show, Lumi. Like I think we're all fairly well-rounded adults at this point.
Yeah, well, my family yourself,
I'm sensitive.
I hurt my family when I tell them those kinds of things.
like if I'm saying something just atrocious on Fresh from the Kitchen, feel free to just come back with something even worse. The people that watch that show will respect you for it, Lumi.
Right.
Never know when it's going to happen. It's just a spur of the moment. I can't plot it out. It's just diary of the mouth. Boom. Out there.
Just think of it like another stream.
Yeah, it happens all the time on Twitch.
Yeah, I think they call that a wet stream. Similar to diarrhea of the mouth, except for there is no filter.
I pooped a tape recorder.
Nice.
That was well timed.
Priceless. That was very nice.
Life was just waiting for the break in the conversation to hit the button.
It wasn't lava.
I found some old snippets that I didn't think I had. Next time Lumi says anything.
You are a smelly pirate hooker.
That's the perfect comeback. There's no retort to you, smelly pirate hooker.
I'm going to punch you right in the ovary. I just popped in here, and now that we've completely gone off the rails here. Sanders, James Posey, Bob Ellis is in the house, Chevy Man, Andrew.
Chevy Man! Booyah!
Booyah!
Oh, Andrew, you know what kind of fuckery you're walking into when you come in here on a Wednesday night.
Yeah, you know better.
That's like walking into a midget wrestling match and seeing somebody who's 4'3" being Andre the Giant style.
I just talked about Mini Kiss this morning. My whole morning show was nothing but about music. It was great.
Mini Kiss.
We should talk about music.
Yeah. Oh. You know they play Chicago, and they play like Nebraska, Omaha. I used to live in Iowa City, and there's a nice live club right there in the heart of Iowa City that anybody going from Chicago to Omaha, they stop there in between.
Oh, you know what I want? Oh, I just thought of the song I wanted to hear Adam do. Punk rock version of Be Interesting. I'll have to load that one up into the comments after the show. I've got a couple now.
Uh-oh.
No, you already know one of them just because I'm hoping that I get to.
I've been down hard, baby.
Oh, yes, yes.
I'm sticking with my Bob Marley and Chop Suey.
Wake up!
Wake up!
Put on the makeup! Are your keys on the table? I wanted to.
You wanted to.
He said, no, I fucking wanted to, goddammit.
You wanted to. I wanted to.
I wanted to.
I did want to.
I'll do what I want.
In my...
That is crazy how the range that man has between yelling and then just fucking blasting all those fucking high notes.
I can tell you that they are they're not a good concert, unfortunately. I had really high hopes for seeing System of a Down live. I saw them right after that album dropped. I have super high hopes for them, just because the energy that's in the music, and it's everybody else in the band just kind of standing there like just going to town on their instrument but not doing anything else. They're not like running around the stage getting crazy, and then there's Serge, he's bouncing around, but when it's just the singer bouncing around, it's just not the show that I expected, especially when like Mudvayne came on. Mudvayne just absolutely fucking killed it. And then Slipknot just destroyed everybody else that was on the stage that night, which they routinely do.
Oh yeah.
Good old Iowa band.
It's still my favorite concert to see is a Slipknot concert. I don't go to concerts very much anymore because I don't like big crowds of people or people in general all that much. But I would go. If Slipknot's coming to town, I think long and hard about that because I know that show is going to fucking just destroy.
Yeah, that's the number one. I've seen them more than anybody else. I've probably seen them almost 20 times now.
Yeah.
Anytime I can get within an hour or two to go see them, I'll make the drive for those guys. They put on the best show I've ever seen in my fucking life.
Yeah, they're Ozzy was notoriously a really good concert back in the day. Iggy Pop was notoriously a really good concert back in the day. Like they're that band right now. It's just like they may not have put any massive hits out in a while, but it's just always going to be a really, really fucking killer show.
Same thing with Rob Zombie, though, too, who does
Zombie was awesome.
Praise, in my opinion. I've seen him a dozen times, and everyone, you know, you expect an hour-long show, and you're at the 3.5-hour mark, and he's rocking out with fucking videos playing behind him and laser show and dancing girls, and you're like, this is awesome!
Yeah.
I did get to see Ozzy back in 96.
Oh, so you're still moving around the stage a bit?
Yeah, he was still moving quite a bit, because that was at... Was at Ozfest in the Ozfest they had at Giant Stadium in the Meadowlands.
Yeah.
The old Giant Stadium.
Yeah. Because now he just kind of stands on the edge of the stage and goes like this the whole time. Yeah,
claps.
I get it, Ozzy. You're like 80 years old. Sharon's got you back out on the road again. Like, I get it, dude.
He was still good then. What was I, 15, 16 at the time when I saw him in 96, I think. And I remember I had to fucking hit the fucking bathroom, running off to the bathroom between sets. Fucking, as I'm going to the bathroom, there's two people fucking right next to the bathroom. Not even in the bathroom. They're just, I'm like,
all right.
Like, I really wanted to go just walk by and give the guy a pat on his back, say good job, don't get caught, but he was like, whatever, fuck it.
So TJ will like the movie The Dirt. Yeah. Check it out.
It was crazy. It was a fantastic concert, though. What's funny is I think it was the day after or what, it was either the day before that or the day after. It was like the fucking Hanson brothers played the same stadium. I was like, oh, that's so fucked up. Because I remember, because Mike's sisters, they were little at the time, like 5 and 6. And so they loved the Hansons because of the whole ba 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 shit that they were doing. And it's not that they really even understood what was going on with all of the preteen girls going, my giny tickles. So,
yeah.
My fucking dad made my sister, who was at the time, she would have been 14 at the time, or 15, I don't remember. He made her take both of my youngest sisters to that concert. It's like, I'm so sorry. And he's like, TJ, you don't have to go. You get to go to Ozfest. I'm like, yes. Well played, Dad. Yes. Yes.
Oh. Yeah.
That was fan-fucking-tastic. He was like, well done, Dad. Well done.
Rollins Band was another really good concert. Rollins Band. Well, it was mostly thanks to Henry Rollins being a fucking maniac.
His band was pretty awesome, though, I remember.
Yeah.
And it was just pretty much him like yelling fucking poetry over like cool fucking heavy and psychedelic riffs, which I mean.
He mostly just does the spoken word stuff now.
Oh, listen.
He goes out on a tour for his spoken word, which is fucking awesome if you ever get a chance to go see that.
Yeah, he's great.
Yeah, Rollins is fantastic. You go, once again, you're going in for an hour show. Like Peter said, you're going in for an hour and like 4 hours later, Rollins is still fucking talking. You're like.
Smart, honest dude, you know?
Yeah. The cool thing is though, if you go and hang out back, if he likes what you're saying, he'll invite you on his tour bus to hang out with him for a little bit.
Yeah, a good example of him is he does Dokken every year over in Germany, the Ossenfest or whatever the fuck it's called.
Yeah,
Dokken, and he'll go on and he's like, they gave me an hour and a half slate. Good luck, folks. And then he starts, and you're just like, hang on every fucking word he says. 3.5 hours later, he's like, all right, so I'm gonna wrap this up now. And you're like, no, you can keep going.
Yeah, you can keep going, Henry. Like like just him bouncing back and forth, like he'll do one of his poems and then all of a sudden he's breaking into a story about when he was with Black Flag, and then there's a story about him trying to out Iggy Pop, you know.
Right. Doing acid driving Ferraris and shit. Yeah. You're like, what the fuck?
Yeah, Rollins, yeah, he's a cool dude, cool guy.
There's a couple of, like, I bet, never had a chance to go see it. I'd venture to guess Arlo Guthrie would be the same way, between bouncing back and forth between music and then fucking stories.
Crazy storytelling. Yeah, I bet that dude's got some fucking tales he could spin.
My mom actually went and saw Arlo Guthrie. It was not that long back. It can't have been more than a decade back that she went and saw him. Like he came to Great Falls, Montana for some weird reason and did a show at like this little room at the big venue there. It was just a little room and there was only like 200 people that were allowed in and expensive ass tickets. But my mom was like, I'm going to see Arlo Guthrie.
Yeah. And what's funny is he's still actually touring, if I remember correctly.
I'm pretty sure he's still out and about somewhere.
Yeah, his old ass is still touring, if I remember correctly, last time I looked into it.
I mean, so's Neil Young, so.
Yeah. That's true. Some of those guys just don't know how to go until they're gone. Willie Nelson.
I'd go see Neil Young, though. I think Neil Young would be a fun concert because he just kind of wanders the stage with his guitar and, you know, like plays to people in the band or in the audience. And I think Neil Young would be a cool concert.
He tells little stories, too. He's this song is about a farmhand. I worked on a ranch in 1976, and he was a real cool cat, and I wrote this song about him.
We didn't always see eye to eye, but one time I was out back smoking weed with him, and then this song I wrote this for him in about 10 minutes. Old man, take a look at my life.
They're like, that's the story behind Old Man. Oh Jesus.
No, speaking of cool storyteller folk, I heard a commercial on the radio the other day when I was running to the store. Apparently, Dolly Parton and Willie Nelson are getting ready to go on tour together.
Oh.
I would see that.
I don't like country. I don't like country music. I would go see that fucking concert.
I'm telling you, that show, just the stories between songs that those two would fucking have.
Duets?
Yeah. Yeah, and then you got the duets on top of that. It'd be like, holy shit, dude, that's awesome.
Yeah, I would definitely see that.
But at this point, you're like, are we sure that's Kenny Rogers? Or did he just get replaced by like someone who kind of sounds like Kenny Rogers? Because that dude looks nothing like himself anymore. All the fucking plastic surgery he had. Holy shit.
Yeah, remember six pack? Oh, he was there. Six pack.
All the TV, all the four TV movies. Gambler 1 through 12. I remember my grandma loved those. Like, you'd go and she's like, I'm recording The Gambler. Like, oh, I guess we'll be hanging out later, Grandma. Got it. Everybody wants to smoke pot with Willie Nelson, Lando. Everybody.
Yeah, I don't even smoke pot anymore. And I would, if I given the chance, I would do it.
Like, well, I've got my job, or I can smoke pot with Willie Nelson. I guess I'm going to smoke pot with Willie Nelson.
Because I can find another job.
Yeah,
but I'll never get another,
I can get another job in the industry. And that'll be my opening line. Like, well, I got fired from my last job because I smoked pot with Willie Nelson.
Fuck
they're
yeah.
Like, they're like, dude, what other stories does this guy have? You're hired, man. Let's bring him in.
Hell yeah.
We have
And then they're going to find out it's just like Twisted Army shit, but... Yeah, I've got my I smoke pot with Willie Nelson on his tour bus.
Hell yeah.
There you go, Slug. I'll never smoke weed with Willie Nelson again.
My cat is acting like she smoked with Willie Nelson. That's why I just got up. She's like running amok throughout the fucking house. I have guitars out that aren't in cases and aren't on stands, so I had to go put them up.
Yeah, I know. If you saw Fresh from the Kitchen last night,
I did.
The little rampagers, the entire show, they were like attacking each other, just random ambushes. Because there's a paper bag, and I think they both love the paper bag, and they fight over the paper bag.
It's a little upsetting that you only brought home one paper bag, knowing you have two cats.
How was I supposed to know that this would lead to so much derision in my solid little clan here?
Little boxes in paper bags are like the cat's kryptonite.
Oh yeah, box that they can just barely fit in, like fats hanging over the side of the box, and they're just sitting there happy as can be, just staring at you like, don't even think about taking this box.
Yeah. It's my fucking box now, bitch.
They can have the box. I want the air pillows that came in with my Amazon order.
Hmm.
I can just walk across those at like 6:30 in the morning. Sounds like gunshots. People wake up.
Pap, 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 pap. Actually, I did that one morning because I wasn't paying attention. Fucking, my son was playing with it the night before, and somebody forgot to pick it up and left it in the hallway. Fucking, there I go, going to the bathroom to go shit, shower, shave, do the whole nine. And pap, pap, pap. I fucking damn near hit the floor, scared the shit out of myself. Because the hallway was dark. Fuck.
There's a lull like this.
Yeah, man, I'll tell you what, that dang old internet, man, you just go on there and point and click, 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 click. It's real easy, man.
Thank you, Boomhauer. Yeah.
Hello, Boomhauer.
Good old Boomhauer.
Click, click, click. Really is, man.
I think
one of my favorite moments of King of the Hill is when you finally find out what Boomhauer does for a living. You're like all the shit that they did on this show.
There's all kinds
that's
of
what he does
on the internet based around that too. It's pretty interesting reads. Like, I don't buy any of it, but it's pretty fun to read, like, people's theories. He's a Texas Ranger, right?
Yeah, he's a Texas Ranger.
Yeah. I think it was like the last episode too. I think like he goes to like the picnic at the like very end of the series, and like they show his wallet on like a dresser or something.
Yeah.
Like, wow.
I'm back on.
Yeah. One of the theories is that he was put on assignment to watch Dale because Dale was deemed a possible threat to the government. But then Boomhauer realizes that he's totally fucking harmless and realizes that he has the easiest job ever because he just is posted up watching a harmless idiot do nothing.
just drinking beer in the backyard.
Yep, and dangle, dangle.
Oh, dang on, dang on. Sound.
Crazy fucking theories about the government.
Right. That would be a pretty cake setup, too.
Dang on.
Bag home, Dillamo, NASCAR.
Oh,
some daggum Hank Hill.
Exactly, Lando.
Yep, the banana box was a good call.
You guys been catching the Road to Reboot videos on Kevin Smith's channel?
Yes.
Oh God, everybody's in that fucking movie. Everybody.
Oh, I can't wait. They wrapped filming 21 days to film. I was like, all right, yeah, it's gonna be awesome.
Yeah, I'm interested. I'll watch anything Kevin Smith. So.
Yeah. Did you catch
there's a couple
emotional about Stan Lee's
cameo
in Captain Marvel.
He's like, and he slipped me into the movie, man.
Kevin's super sensitive.
Yeah,
he is.
Well, he's like one of us that like just happened to have like a couple of movies that did fairly well.
Yeah,
just like Clerks was just like that 90s generation. Like it just speaks to all of us.
Especially if you watch Fat Man Chronicles.
Yeah.
Fat Man Chronicles with him basically standing in the cantina doing just off the cuff riffing shit for 2 hours.
Yeah.
Him and Mark. Talks a lot about behind the scenes shit during that too. You get to learn a lot more about the regular Kevin Smith during Fat Man Chronicles, I feel.
Oh yeah. Well, I listened to a lot of his podcasts too, like Smodcast
and Smodcast. Smodcast is good too.
The best is the emo Kev recording.
Yes.
like 14 years old.
He's like 13 or 14, yeah. And he's like riding his bike being all emo. He like invented emo. Him and Scott Mosier are just like, oh my God. And they just stop the tape every 5 seconds, like, what a little bitch. Just making fun of a 14-year-old Kevin Smith.
Yeah. Best part of any of those podcasts is to hear how many times that lighter starts.
I know, you can always
you're like, all right, 10 minutes from now he's
the contact high that Scott Mosier's getting. It's gotta be insane.
Yep.
Oh man, yeah, I used to listen to those like religiously. I've fallen off of them. Like, I haven't listened to them regularly in a couple months, maybe like 3 or 4 months, but I'll play catch up these weekends and listen to them all and binge them.
It's harder for me. I used to have an iPad that I sat in front of my work computer and I would just listen to them as they came out and got cut up. And then now it's like a pain to get them on like Android or whatever. These, you have to go out and download them and all of that shit. That's the thing that Apple has, is the freaking iPads and iPhones that automatically get those podcasts. Perfect.
Mm-hmm. And that they're fucking overpriced. For what they do, they're overpriced. I'll say that is, I still love Macs, even though I'm running a PC now, but they're really fucking overpriced. But the simplicity and how they've thought to make everything so user-friendly on them, I think that's why they're able to drive the price so high, is the simplicity of use for them.
Now, the phone that I was waiting for, and I think you guys probably already know this, was that Razer V4.
Yes.
Fucking one with it folds out to a 7.5-inch screen, but folds down into a clam like a regular old school Razer. I'm like, all their talks is, oh, it's going to be affordable. Fucking $1,500.
Affordable, my ass.
I was pissed, man. I was like, are you, like, you promised me like a $500 phone.
I can buy two fucking 81 Chevettes and pay for insurance for a year for that price.
Jeez. That's not even right.
Why you gotta make fun of the Chevette? Some people like those.
Oh, that was, my first car was a 79 Chevette. It was great. I bought it for $75. $75.
The 79 Chevette. It was his first car.
I had a friend that had 10 of them. He would not pay a penny over $75 for each one of them, but he had 10 of them.
The Chevette
and
Club.
His big brother had a small block 305 just sitting in the garage. He measured. The motor mounts on the Chevette would fit a small block 305. We had to cut out the firewalls to change the spark plugs, but we put that fucker in there. Oh, put some Baja tires on the back of it and found some railroad tracks that were like this. And just wrapped that thing up and got airborne.
Jeez.
Oh, that's fantastic. Actually, that's been one of my shows. I've been watching a lot of fucking, for some odd reason, car rebuilding shows lately. I don't know why. Not like shit like Diesel Brothers and stuff like that. No, I'm talking like YouTube shows where people are fucking going out and doing it on their own. It's been like a fucking bad hobby lately.
Yeah. Did you see the one with the guy who rescued a Fiero from the farm field? He goes through the entire thing. He's been sitting for 20 years, got it home, went through all the different... all the tubes, the vacuum tubes, and everything all the way through. Got the engine, everything, all the tubes and everything replaced. Put gas in it and fired up.
Oh.
He had a ton of other work to do on it, but like the transmission was totally shot. He had to replace that. He replaced a whole bunch of stuff from rust. But he's like, that's what I always wanted when I was 16. And now I get it when I'm 35.
I got lucky. I had a buddy whose dad got him one for his 16th birthday. So we cruised in that motherfucker all the fucking time.
The bad thing is when I was in the band, I was the sober one. And the lead singer had one of those. And he's like, oh, dude, you got to drive us home. I couldn't fit in the fucking seat. I could fit in the passenger seat, but I couldn't get my big old fat thigh from underneath of the steering wheel in there. I'm like, dude, we're gonna walk. I can't drive your car.
Leva, you can drive my car. Ding, ding, ding.
I hated that. I wanted to drive that car bad. It was in the middle of winter in Iowa. Nice snowy, icy roads. All you had to do was feather that gas pedal, and you went sideways with that car.
Yep.
We took off one night, fresh snow in the middle of the intersection. You went and put the gas on, and without even trying, we're doing a full donut in the middle of the intersection, and then off.
Vapor, you son of a bitch! You. Handsome son of a bitch.
He works too much. I've discovered this last night. Works too
much. You're just now discovering this? Like, he should be on all the shows.
Yeah.
Welcome to being a cook.
Yeah, right.
Loomy braids.
Those loomy braids can get to kicking.
Yay! Which one did you put on there?
This is the same one. I'm just rewicking.
Doggy wants some.
Oh, come on.
Dog says, I want some loomy braids. Do I smell chihuahua?
Meter just got a plastic bag full of meter or loomy braids, and he hasn't even used them yet.
Use them till the fucking wheels fall off. That's how you do that.
Man, that's way more than you sent me, loomy.
Right.
I only knew how to make like two braids back when I sent you a braid.
Plus, those were birthday braids, so neener neener.
All right, guys, I gotta check off because 5 o'clock is gonna come early.
Have a good night, Lifa. Just know I'll be thinking of you
before you go. Before you go, one thing I want you to know. First game of the NFL season, September 9th, Packers-Bears. First kickoff of the season. So, just saying, we've got an early bet to make in come September time frame. I'm just saying.
I've
got
to save some money, huh? All right.
Awesome. Yeah, one of us does, because the way we looked last year, it's probably going to be me.
Well, I
mean, you guys actually spent some money on your team this year.
Yeah, they did.
I'm going to leave you with these words.
Fuck you, fuck you, fuck you. You're cool. Fuck you, I'm out.
Well played, sir. You're a gentleman in a scrotum.
Good old half-baked. I don't know how many times I saw that in the theater. It was it was a ridiculous amount of times, though, I will tell you that.
Likewise. And I was full-baked when I saw it.
I was sober in the Army, but I still went and laughed my head off. I've been there.
You know, that I can say that is the bummer about having a three-year-old. I have not been to a theater to go watch a movie I want to see in almost 4 years now, since prior to my son being born. Oh, no, I take that back. One time, and that's because my parents decided they were going to be nice enough to watch my son so we could go to a movie, which is fan-fucking-tastic, but one fucking time. Everything I do, now I have to watch on Netflix or other means to find movies that I want to watch that are still in theaters and things of that nature. I'm just saying, allegedly, there's places out there to watch that other than in the movie theater. Allegedly, exactly.
I can tell you I'll be at opening night of Avengers. I can tell you that right now.
I want to be.
I don't care if I have to mug a little kid in the parking lot for his ticket.
Fuck you, bastard. Oh, this is your dad? Fuck you, too. Who needs a spare ticket?
That's cool. Jax Miller probably wanted to come to the movie, too.
I was about to say, right for Jax.
Didn't expect to get choked out with the Captain America shield at the Avengers premiere, did you?
Why doesn't Rye have a wrench here?
Get a third ticket for me, too.
Are you coming up here?
While you're mugging people.
Are you coming up here?
You can mail it to me.
What good is it going to do you down there?
Why don't you just have you and Jax take a little field trip down here, and then we all three get to go see it.
Darts.
And then you can mug somebody in Virginia who possibly will be open carrying.
So I can take their gun and pistol whip them with it?
Pistol whip. Just a big old dollop on the barrel.
A girl can dream,
right? Yeah, Vaporite does have a point, TJ.
I'm trying to figure out why he doesn't have a wrench here. Just sworn I gave him one at one point. There you go. Fixed.
Lando, you missed Adam denouncing that song and saying that it will never see the light of day again. That's what you missed. Living La Vida Lando was a one-time only play. If you didn't catch it at the start, it's gone now.
Google will officially be scrubbing it from its records.
Yep, TJ's erasing the first couple minutes of the show.
Yep.
Sorry.
Which famous hat are you referring to there, Rye?
I think he's referring to the party hat.
The party hat? Should have the party hat right here.
It's ready. He's ready for the season.
Well, since you asked, I must oblige, even though it's fucking warm in here.
What you got there, meter babes?
Secret sauce!
Oh!
Secret sauce.
I also have some secret sauce.
There you go.
I also have some secret sauce.
Oh, shit.
Oh, wait. Are we talking about e-liquid? Never mind.
There, the party hat is on. We're good to go.
We're living La Vida, Lando.
Oh,
His lips are devil red, skin's the color of mocha.
Like a really, really, really like heavy on the coffee froth mocha.
Yeah. Yeah, for sure.
Lots of milk foam.
Yeah, there's I'm willing to bet the ratio is probably like 99-1 on the milk to coffee ratio on the Lando.
I'm there, right there with them.
Me too.
Lando,
I develop a little color because I'm out bicycle riding all the time, but usually it's about July before I actually pick up enough to where I'm like, okay, color adjustment can go away for a minute. Don't want to terrify everybody. Have a good one, Rodrigo.
Later, Rodrigo. Later, brother. Put those little bastards to bed. Tell the bastards you love them and that they're still bastards. That's what I do to mine every day.
Oh. So we're, less than a month till the draft, right?
Yeah.
Like this is the last big event before the football drought starts.
Yep. And you have a drought for like 5 months and then preseason. Yeah.
April 25th,
yeah. So we're less than a month.
Yeah.
Speaking of preseason, I did see the Packers and Raiders are talking about taking a game not over the pond or over the pond for a preseason game. Over to Europe somewhere.
Yeah, I heard in 2020 the Niners are considering giving up a home game to go play in China.
Whoa! Nice.
Yeah,
that's a big one. I don't know how the market would be there for that.
Oh, the Chinese love any sports. They're down.
But they can't call it football over there because football. I guess it would be American football.
Yep. Yeah, American football.
No footy here.
Want to play a bit of footy?
Like, if you go to China, shouldn't you get like a double bye week, like the week before and the week after? Like, shouldn't you?
Just for travel.
Just to recover from that bullshit. Because I've flown to the region where China's at, and that's a miserable fucking flight.
Yeah,
I can't even imagine that long.
What from? Because let's see, if you go to that area, let's say you're going to South Korea, you have to go. Usually, it's Hawaii, Japan into Korea.
Jeez.
We did. It was SeaTac to Okinawa, and then Okinawa into Seoul, Seoul, down south of Seoul. Shit, where are the big airports at?
Says, you know where the fuck you are.
Yeah, you know where the fuck you are. Osan.
My fucking head.
About an hour south of Seoul. Seoul is enormous. Seoul is a ridiculously huge city. I will tell you that. That might have been one of the biggest cities I've ever been in. Because you start driving in it, and like 3 hours later, you're still driving through Seoul.
That's a big fucking city.
I'd love to go there. I'd love to go to Tokyo too, but I just, oh man, that's just that's a long plane ride. Same with Australia and New Zealand too, two places.
Oh, dude, I'm planning a trip to New Zealand.
That would be so cool.
I want to go to that one too.
You want to go to that one too?
Yes.
Plane ride down to the lower 48 from Alaska is almost 29 hours straight.
Oh, God.
Did that twice.
What?
Yeah, and I don't fly well.
Humanity.
At all.
It's a really long fucking flight. Ugh.
It is. I consumed a lot of alcohol on that flight.
Usually two to put myself to sleep, and then when I wake up, two more to put myself back to sleep on something that long.
We almost missed our connector in Atlanta because I was at the bar.
So close.
True story.
I think we almost missed our connector out of Iraq and Amsterdam because we all stopped to grab a beer and a smoke.
Hell yeah.
Yeah. And like all of a sudden here comes this major come rushing out and he's like, there you guys are. What the fuck? We're like, huh? We still got like 30 minutes before the flight. And they're like, no, they need everybody now. I'm like, oh.
Dude, when we went to fucking Afghanistan, I had a cocksucker of a first sergeant. everybody on this fucking plane, rest of the battalion, okay to deboard, go smoke, do what you gotta do. Our fucking company, no. You sit your ass in the seat, don't fucking move. You fucking...
What the fuck's the point of that?
He was a cocksucker like that. He fucking was one of those micromanagers. That motherfucker, I remember one day, he was trained as a... Was he? He was a whiskey. He's a medic. Nothing wrong with medics. Have nothing wrong with medics at all. He tried to come in and tell me how to take an x-ray. I was like, Top, with all due respect, you can get the fuck out of my office because you have no clue what you're talking about.
Yeah.
He goes, I know this machine better than you do. Okay, Top. What's this called? Okay. Thank you, Top. Have a good day. Bye. Then later I was doing push-ups for that.
Jeez.
What a fucking dick. He's a goddamn dick with ears.
That's the chain of command can just ruin something.
It was great because then, like, that motherfucker, he spent a lot of time in K2 in Karshikhanabad, which is Uzbekistan.
Yeah.
The staging area for where they used to go into Afghanistan.
Yeah.
He did not like downrange at all. Apparently, he would go to check on the other soldiers that were downrange, and he wouldn't even stay 24 hours. Fucking hop flight in, hop flight out. Helicopter in, helicopter out. Hey, how you doing? You good? You need anything? Bye. Like, dude. And gets all the fucking MSMs and all that other bullshit.
Like they always do. I still chuckle about our commander that we had over there, and he, like, the rumors were swirling like crazy about when the stop loss was going to get released and when everybody was going to be able to go home because the actual war in Iraq didn't take all that long. And so essentially we're sitting there, and as far as we can tell, they don't really need us. You know, like we've got like two wards full of people out of like eight, and they're setting up permanent hospitals further up the road. And so they didn't need us. And so the rumors start swirling. All right, we're going to be heading back because, you know, we're not really doing anything. And this asshole lines everybody up in formation in Iraq. Comes out there and yells at us for like 30 minutes. You're going to be here up to 2 years.
Oh, wow.
Like 2 years, dude? Really? Like the stop loss is going to get released any day. And then the second that happens, like 3/4 of your people are out because the majority of us were getting out and they sent us here because they were stop lossing us.
Yep. And that's the easiest way to keep somebody longer. In. You stop lost. Guess what? You're going over there.
Yep. That's exactly what happened. Like everybody in the hospital where I was stationed at the time, they're like, yep, report to the cash on Monday. Oh, good. Thanks.
Dicks.
And then all the soldiers that, you know, are planning on making a career, they're like, can we go? They're like, no, you can't. It's fun being like one of like 20 people wandering around with combat patch on for a while, though. That was pretty hilarious. Like people would start trying to give you like life advice and you just kind of turn your combat patch at them like, you're gonna tell me how to live my life.
I love that when you get like a fresh LT after coming back and there's no combat patch and I'm like, they try to say something and I just slowly rotate my right shoulder over to them and go, yeah,
like,
oh, I'm like, sorry, sir. Did you know about this? Oh, you didn't.
Oh, that would suck. Being down in the Balkans for that shit.
Yeah, definitely not my idea of a good time.
No. Yeah, there's all sorts of little skirmishes all around the world that they don't talk about much unless you're actually in the service and you're like, ooh, Jesus, that doesn't sound like it was a good time at all. And then you hear about other ones like fucking Panama where they're like, yeah, we just kind of went in and hung out on the beach and like shit was over by the time we got there. So, but we were just like rolling around for like 6 months. Pretty sweet. Oh, okay.
God damn it. where the fuck was I?
I know. They're like, I'm planning on retiring to Panama, actually. I had such a good time.
I met a pretty Panamanian.
And I know
Adam's next song.
Says I know what the cost of living is. And I know exactly
cost of living is pennies.
I know exactly what I need to do to not get malaria there.
Serbia and Kosovo? Yeah.
There's always some shit going down over there.
We had to go clean up landmines in Bosnia, and that was in 98 or 99. That was fucking bullshit. Engineer company, though. Good times. That I still think my favorite story about that was on the in briefing when we were all sitting in the tent. And they're like, and if you hear a shot and nobody gets hit, it's just a warning shot from one of the farmers. Get out of wherever you're at. They don't want you there.
Wow.
It's like, if nobody gets hit. Got it. So what happens if somebody gets hit? Return fire. Like, okay.
No man left behind.
No man left behind. That was. There are so many people that have gotten killed over that nonsense idea.
Yeah.
Like, if somebody's wounded, I get it. Somebody's dead. Like, there's so many people that got killed.
Oh, yeah.
So many people that got, like, if you watch that movie, we Were Soldiers, it's fucking infuriating, is what that movie is. It's fucking infuriating to me.
But there's quite a few of them out there that I see like that are pretty fucking infuriating where I'm going now.
Although, I was referring to wounded, not dead.
There are some other things that I do watch where I'm going, yes, yes, yes. Do the right thing. Fuck them. And there's some things that are just completely off the wall that I really love. Like old Brad Pitt and fucking Nazi killing. Killing Nazis.
Killing Nazis.
Fucking
Grazie.
It's all right.
Mid-20 men!
You want to surrender? All right, come here. We're going to make you surrender, but people aren't going to forget.
Gonna go live in your house in Pennsylvania? That's fine.
Thank you, Swag.
Swaggy Shane!
I guess I'll remove my message then.
It's only because my button was frozen.
I was getting a twitchy finger. I was like, huh?
Huh? Like, Mace, shouldn't we just hide you from the channel?
Yep.
Ain't no room on this channel for that.
Yeah, to the Nizzo.
We'll teach you all sorts of shit that you'd never, never need to learn.
That's it. Like, the best part of you ran down the crack of your mama's ass and into her fucking shoes.
I want a big fluffy puppy. Tell him to come over and snuggle with me.
Who's got a big fluffy puppy? I've got a not so fluffy kitty over there.
His couch.
I've got another not so fluffy kitty right over there.
Me just sharing a chair with the giant dog.
Yeah, his dog's like, fuck you. This is my chair.
No, fuck you.
This was your chair, asshole.
I get an allotment of like this much cushion on the front left corner. Because that way they have something to push off against to push into the cushion on the back and the side. Although I will say the little one is smart because he figured out to go up on top and then he can push off the 100-pound dog that lays over on this side to get himself better positioning.
I love it.
Beasts, I tell you.
To be honest, I don't know why I'm still awake.
Zilla!
Oh, snap.
Zilla!
What up, Zilla?
Why are you all still?
I was going to say, I found one of the best bicycling songs I've run across so far throughout cycling. And it makes odd sense. It is the Two Princes by Spin Doctors.
Nice. I just heard that the other night on the way home from work.
Yeah.
I can ride my bike with no handlebars.
It's a little bit too slow pace to be a good bicycle song, but yeah, that because it just starts out that, and then the rhythm just holds steady the whole way through, and it's a lively song. I listened to it like 3 times in a row. I was almost home. I was like, man, I'm making really good pace right now. I'll just keep jamming to this. I can listen to it like 3 times and not get irritated at it.
Right.
It's almost Thursday. You're right,
Volker. It's just one of those songs that, like, you hate to admit, but you like it.
What, the Spin Doctors?
Yeah.
I like both of their hits.
Both of their songs, right?
Right.
Like, you watch that video and you can just smell the weed smoke coming off that dude, coming off that dude's wool sweaters.
Absolutely. 1, 2. Prince is here, bound for you. It's what I said.
The other one
Little Miss Wrong.
Yeah. Right. I have no fucking idea what he's saying.
Right. With the Spin Doctors, for whatever reason, that lead singer always reminds me of like what the snake dance would be if it came to life and took on a personality.
Oh, dude, like he did, like at the start of the song, he does a spin, and then like the rest of the time, you're right, he's just kind of
the hippie floaty snake dance.
Oh, Blues Traveler is actually pretty good.
Hell yeah,
pretty good cycling music.
It's already up, Spork Leafy. Go check it out.
Yep,
request some tunes.
Yeah, request 2 of your own songs.
You know, I don't even know why I request shit. When it comes to stuff like that where it's lottery based, I don't fucking win anything. So I'm like, why am I doing this?
I thought the same thing, and then I got it. Except I wish I got my other one. But I like it still. I gave it to my mom and my sister today. My mom and sister now are like, where's his YouTube channel? And I was like, he doesn't have one yet.
I'm going to be the first 2-time winner. I feel it.
I'm just saying.
I feel it in my bones.
There's 10 fucking songs there already.
There's a conspiracy theory going on. One of those songs.
Ask Lumi. I was playing that Foo Fighters Best of You song on my guitar a couple nights ago. I was like, damn it, why didn't this song win? I love this song. I really want to do this song.
It is what it is. It is what it is.
It's like, I could rock this song, man. I'd have to stand like a fucking foot away from my microphone. And that whole song is just belting.
Yeah. It really is. That dude's got a fucking set of lungs on him.
Hell yeah.
Speaking of him, I was fucking going back through watching some older videos, and I watched his part of the speech he gave at Lemmy's fucking ceremony. Dude. Man.
Yep.
He's another one of those guys that's you wouldn't think it, but he's a real big softy.
Mm-hmm, definitely.
And considering what a badass he is, breaking his fucking leg and finishing a concert while a doctor sat there and held it in place the whole fucking time.
Yeah, that's crazy.
Did that song chart? Let's find out.
Sure. I have faith it did.
Faith by George Michael?
It went mainstream terrestrial radio pretty fucking heavy here in the Midwest.
Which one?
Why known as Big Brown Beaver.
Oh, Primus. Yeah. I actually like Primus a lot, actually. I think it's their fucking bass lines are fantastic.
Oh, yeah.
Did it chart, though? That's the question. Did it chart? It has to be a top 100 hit.
I bet it did. That song was pretty huge.
That's what I'm saying. I bet it went top 100. It might not have went number one, but I bet it broke 100.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. I was on MTV on more than one occasion that I remember, at least back in the day when MTV still played music.
Yeah, right?
I'm wrong. I'm watching all that stuff.
Ha!
Peaked at number 12 or number 23?
Alternative, U.S. Alternative Rock Tracks. It did 12, mainstream rock 23, airplay 62. That's actually a surprise to me. So it did indeed chart.
Yeah, Claypool was the fucking god for a while in the Midwest here. It was right after that shit, then Frog Brigade came around and everybody was like, oh my god.
If that one wins, I gotta borrow a five string bass.
Like, you're going to burn your fingers up hitting that baseline.
Challenge round for sure.
Yep. You'll have to borrow my bass player Jesse's five string. I can't bring my bass down to B. String would just be like. Like, I can play a five string. I just choose not to and letting the arsons. Fifth string just gets in the way.
Fuck, it's already 10:56. Holy shit. All right, we got to go around the room and get the fuck out of here. Time to get the geese and get the flock out of Dodge.
Plus, my credit, we probably should play that song again since it's gonna be the last time Lando will ever hear it.
Yep, because I hate this, but this is one I refuse to play again, so it'll get
played. It'll be played on my channel. Don't worry, Lando. I fucking love it.
I love it, but it makes me hate myself. That's the problem. And I don't feel like hating myself. I like myself too much.
I had to record it.
Who wants to go first? Get us the fuck out of here.
I'll go. I'm Adam. Join the group on Facebook. It's called Music Time with Adam on Golf Tee Vapes. Pick two songs and maybe you'll win. And it will hopefully be ridiculous and awesome. And check out my bands, Eddie and the Arsons and the Disheartened, because we make music for people.
Pretty sweet music too.
Enjoy it. Thanks, Fresh. On that note, I'll pass it to Fresh. Thanks for having me, TJ. Go, Fresh, go.
Hi, everybody. I'm Fresh O3.
Have a pretty good master plan for Saturday. Saturday's going to be a ton of fun. We got some good folks coming on. We've got a good show planned out for next Tuesday. Friday, absolutely no plan. Absolutely no plan, unless something comes up the next day or so. So, yeah, swing on over to my channel, Fresh O3. Check it out. We'll do some tasty mixing, hang out, bullshit, talk about the evils in the world, and see if we can come up with a plan to write them. That's all I got, everybody. Go to the Pink Pussy List, thepinkpussylist.com. Use a coupon code on all the sites that are listed there. Adori Liquid and VSO flavors are getting my special attention tonight. Because Dawn is awesome. She always deserves our support. And Swaggy Thane is also a pretty awesome guy. Pretty awesome guy. And he does make the best blueberry concentrate on the planet. So I have a hard time not saying to support those two. So everybody be beautiful to each other. Educate, advocate, be good for this community. I'm going to toss it to the looms since I don't really have much of a choice. Toss it to the looms.
Oh, wow.
I'll eat the looms. Dunk it.
Wow. You don't dunk have it, a looms. Choice? You don't dunk have it, a looms. Choice?
Dunk it. I threw you the alley-oop. You're like 6'3". Get up there and jam it. Throw it down tomahawk style. You already threw a Michael Jordan three-pointer. Take off from the free throw line. Catch that alley-oop and just...
I don't do this planned. It just comes out of my mouth. Anywho, since Fresh had nobody else to pass it to.
Hi, my name's Lumi. I've been vaping for about a year.
I'm Lumi. I like to build coils. I like to sell my coils. I like to strum on Twitch. I like being here. I like seeing you all pretty faces. Thanks for having me. Thanks for chat participants and viewers. Passing it to Pissy Pants.
I'll take Pissy Pants. That's all right. Speaking of the Pissy Pants varieties, I want to say big shout out to my 3-year-old who has finally made it through the night for the last week not pissing himself. Oh, fucking huge. Moving in the right direction there. Also,
good job, little guy.
Shout out to Eddie and the Arsons, because today I introduced my son to Eddie and the Arsons via YouTube on the TV, and my son was fucking rocking and jamming out right in the fucking living room. He's throwing fucking horns up and everything. He's fucking, yes!
Sweet.
Do it. It's like, Dad, they're good. Who's that? I'm like, that's Eddie and the Arsons. How do you know about them, Dad? I know a guy. And then I also know another guy, but that's a whole different story. most importantly, for everyone who came out, thank you for coming out. I appreciate it. Love you guys. That's the reason why I continue to come out. I do see Rye put something out there. He is going to be going live on the Instagrams after the show is over. to shoot. Ooh, he's gonna be shooting Don's banana bondage. Somebody's getting some fancy picture work taken right there.
Go join that handsome son of a gun.
He's gonna be shooting some of this. Shooting some of that stuff right there. The hotness. Oh. Most definitely though, go check out adoreeliquid.com. Go fill your carts with little purple hearts. You will not be disappointed. So head on over to Vaping Swag, VSO.store, any of those. And if you're the bearded variety, go check out Swaggy Shane for some of those fine beard ailments or oils for your beard ailments. Excuse me. And like Fresh said earlier, anything on the pinkpussylist.com. Anything there, fantastic for you. They do fantastic things for us. Go help them out. And also go and fucking put a song request in over on the page there. Makes the show fun. We'll have another one here, another new one in 2 weeks here. In the meantime, probably make something else, because I'll do Live in the Vida Loco one more time, just because, well, Lando is loco, so it seems all but fitting since he's out there tonight. Other than that, I don't have a lot to say other than a reminder. Do your part. Educate. Advocate. Not for yourselves. Not for me. Not for anybody on this panel here. For those people that have come behind us to make the switch from the stinkies that have not made the switch yet, we have to keep it alive for them. Remember, like I said earlier at the beginning of the show, you can make a difference on your local level. Go in if you see something's going on. Say your piece. Fight it. Fight it with all you got, because you know what? It starts at the ground level. You can't get to the top if you don't start at the bottom and work your way up. That's just how it works. So, keep fighting. Love y'all. I don't know. I'm going to send it over to the one, the only, the Meter Vapes.
First and foremost, thank you, TJ, as always, for having a show Wednesday night where crazy folks like ourselves can live our La Vida Loca here vicariously through Adam's guitar work. Your homework for this week, folks. You're going to go to eddieandthearsons.com, and you're going to put that in your ear hole, and you will be happy. And then you're going to go over to Fresh03's YouTube channel, and you're going to stay tuned because he's got not one but two more shows coming up this weekend for you to tune into. Then you're going to go over to Lumi's Twitch drum. You're going to watch that, and when you hear her cussing people out for the way that the gameplay unfolded, you're going to laugh so hard that you have to go, and you're going to go buy yourself some of these fucking amazing braids that she makes, because it will vape your face hole clean the fuck off, and you will enjoy it. When you're done with that, you're going to go to TJ's YouTube channel and you're going to go share it with a friend, because we deserve the fucking ball pit. And the only way to get there is to tell more people about this damn channel and get more folks on board. But other than that, there's no big spiel this week. You don't have to do everything, but you do have to do something. So keep yourself educated, because as it's been said a million times, and it will be said a million times more, if we don't band together, we will be banned together.
All right, on that note, are you guys ready to watch Lando go loco one more time?
Shh, let it happen.
Who wants to take us out before we let Lando go loco?
Remember, as you go through your week this week, try and be kind to someone, if at all possible. Open some doors, give a stranger a hug, and then run, because they'll probably press charges. And get off your butts and vape.
Bye!
Bye!
Superstitions, black cats and voodoo dolls. I feel a premonition that girl's gonna make me fall. She's into new sensation, new kicks in the candlelight. She's got a new addiction for every day and night. She'll make you take your clothes off and go dancing in the rain. York City in a funky cheap hotel. She took my heart, she took my money. Must have slipped me a sleeping pill. She never drinks the water, makes you order French champagne.